My dear pharmacy iconer friends, today I am here with another subject of DPharm Part 2, Drugstore and Business Management. The purpose of the subject, Drugstore and Business Management, is to discuss about the basic concept of business and business management to run drugstores. As per Education Regulation 1991, Drugstore and Business Management syllabus is divided into two parts. Part 1, Commerce. Here, different chapters are there, like different forms of business organizations, channels of distribution, drug house management, inventory control, sales promotion, recruitment training, evaluation and compensation of pharmacists, and finally banking and finance. Part 2, Accountancy, includes various chapters like accounting concepts and conventions, recording of business transactions, financial statements, and budgeting. Now we will discuss about commerce. Commerce is the aspect of business activity which is concerned with the distribution of goods and services produced by the industry. Commerce acts as an important role as a bridge in between the producer and consumer. Producers are producing goods and services by the industries, and these goods and services are reached to the hand of the consumer through commerce. Commerce is associated with the sales, profit, and marketing. These three issues are interconnected to each other to perform commerce. Various branches of commerce include trade and aids to trade. Trade is the combination of purchase and sale. Aids to trade are not actually the trading activities, but aids to trade activities are associated with the trading activities. Important activities called as aids to trade are banking, warehousing, advertisement and salesmanship, insurance, communication, transport, and distribution. Trade is called as the nucleus of commercial activities. Trade is the exchange of various goods and services in return of money or other goods. Buying, selling, and exchange of goods or services for money or money's worth is called as trade. Dealers or distributors for the distribution of goods and services from the production to the consumers at far off places are known as traders. If we classify trade, we can classify like that: internal or domestic trade and international or foreign trade. Internal or domestic trade includes sale and exchange of goods or services within a country. Internal or domestic trade is classified into two types: wholesale trade and retail trade. In wholesale trade, the traders buy the goods in large quantities directly from the manufacturer and sell these in smaller quantities to the retailers. Various examples of wholesale trading are super stockist, stockist, distributors, dealers, etc. In contrast, retail trade supply the goods in small quantities directly to the consumer, as for example, chemist outlet, retail drugstore, etc. Retail trade act as a bridge in between the wholesale trading operation and the consumer. They are responsible to supply the goods or services directly to the consumer. In contrast, wholesale trade acts as a bridge in between the producer and retail trade. International or foreign trade includes sale and exchange of goods or services among different countries. Goods or services are exchanged in between two or more than two countries are often called as international or foreign trade activities. International or foreign trade can be classified into three categories like import, export and import. When a trader of one country purchases goods or services from the trader of another country, it is called as import. When a trader of one country sells goods or services to the trader of other countries, it is called as export. When a trader purchases goods or services from one country and sells the same goods or services to the traders of other countries, it is called as intra-port trade. There are various advantages of foreign trade. Increase in government income, industrialization, benefits to the consumers, cultural development, export of excess production, availability of all types of goods, more profit, and foreign exchange. Various disadvantages of foreign trade are shortage of goods in a country, incentive to colonization, exploitation, bad effects on the home economy, effect on culture, fear of dumping, foreign competition, mutual dependence in between various countries. Aids to trade is also called as activities revolving around the trade. These are associated with the trading but not actually the trading activities. These activities are banking, transport, warehousing, insurance, packaging, advertising and publicity. All these activities revolving around the trade are responsible to reduce various types of hindrances associated with the trading. Banking is the activities known as aids to trade which reduces hindrances of finance. To start a drugstore, a capital is required. The banking is the activity which can facilitate the finance. A large amount of money is required for the production and marketing of goods and services. The banking are responsible to facilitate such capital. The finance can be raised from the own resources, commercial banks, shares, debentures, financial institutions, trade creditors, etc. Banking systems provides the following services to the customers. It provides loans and advances for the purchase of raw materials and machinery. It also provides overdraft facilities. It allows the facilities of discounting of bills. It provides foreign exchange, issuing letters to the creditors, etc., thus giving assistance to the foreign trade. Transport system removes the hindrances of place. Process of carrying the goods and persons from one place to another is the transport activities. Transport assists the trade by moving goods from one place to another place to the location where they are to be sold. Transportation plays an important role in the economic development also. Various types of transport activities are seen. Surface transport includes road, railways transport. Water transport includes the transportation via river and sea and airways transportation. Warehousing are the places where goods are stored. It removes hindrance of time. The goods may be supplied to the consumer as and when required. There are various types of warehouses like private warehouses, public warehouses and bonded warehouses. Public warehouses are operated by the business firms which provide storage facilities to the general public for certain charges. Private warehouses are generally run by the private organizations. These are operated by the big business concerns or wholesalers for the storage of their own stocks. Bonded warehouses are the licensed warehouses to accept imported goods for the storage until the payment of the custom duties are made. Generally, bonded warehouses are situated at the ports. Warehousing is required to maintain the stability in prices. It is required to ensure availability of goods throughout the year in spite of the fact that the same is produced only during a particular season. It is required to ensure the continuous availability of goods in the market. Its proper storage is essential. Certain goods such as drugs, chemicals, etc. are required to be properly stored or warehoused to prevent their destruction or damage. Insurance is one of the aids to trade which removes hindrance of risk. Various types of risk are associated with the business activities like fire, accidents, thefts, storm, floods, earthquake, price reduction, changes in demand and supply conditions, dishonesty of employees and partners, strikes, lockouts, and pilferage, etc. There are various kinds of insurance, like general insurance, life insurance, fire insurance, and marine insurance. General insurance covers the risk of loss due to theft or specified happening. So, various general causes are associated with the general insurances, which removes the hindrances of risk. Life insurance are associated with the payment of stipulated sum of money to the insured person or expiry of a specified number of years or on his or her earlier death. Fire insurance is associated with the risk of fire. In this case, the insurance company undertakes to make a payment equal to the volume of goods or lost or damage suffered as a result of fire. Marine insurance covers the risk associated with the loss or damage to the insured vessel, cargoes, or passengers during the transportation on the high seas. Packaging refers to the wrapping, crating, filling, and compression of goods. It is concerned with the creation and designing of proper package for different products. Packaging ensures the supply of the products of right quality, right quantity, and weight to the consumers. There are various functions of packaging. Important functions are protection to the product, symbolically communication, it provides customer convenience, it promotes the product. Advertising and publicity is one of the aids to trade which removes the hindrance of knowledge or information gap about the availability and uses of goods in between traders and consumers. The main objective of advertisement is to create the demand and to increase the sales. There are various methods of advertising and publicity like TV, radio, newspaper, magazines, wall posters, pamphlets, free samples, trade fairs, exhibitions, balloons, and window display, etc. Industry. The term industry refers to that part of the business activity which relates to the production, processing, or fabrication of products. The goods are called consumer goods if used by final consumers, and capital or producer goods if used in production of other goods. If we will try to classify various kinds of industry, we can classify industries on the basis of types of goods produced. On the basis of the types of goods produced, industry can be classified into four major categories like genetic industries, extractive industries, manufacturing industries, and construction industries. Manufacturing industries can be further classified like that: analytical industries, synthetic industries, processing industries, and assembling industries. Genetic industries are responsible for producing and multiplying certain species of plants and animals for the purpose of earning profit from their sale, as for example, breeding farms, poultry farms, etc. Extractive industries are concerned with the extraction or drawing out the products from the natural resources such as soil, air, or water. As for example, oil exploration, fishing, agricultural, hunting, etc. are the examples of extractive industries. Construction industries includes the construction of roads, buildings, canals, bridges, dams, etc. Manufacturing industries engage in production of goods wherein the raw materials or semi-manufactured goods are converted into the finished products. As for example, pharmaceutical industry. Manufacturing industries are further subdivided into four categories like analytical industries, synthetic industries, processing industries, and assembling industries. Analytical industries engage in manufacturing of products by analyzing and separating different elements from the same material. As for example, fractional distillation of crude oil refinery industries. Synthetic industries are these industries where two or more than two materials are mixed together in a manufacturing process to make a new product. Products like various chemicals, drugs, soaps, cosmetics, fertilizers, etc. are produced by the synthetic industries. Processing industries includes processing through different stages of production to produce the final product. Pharmaceutical industries, paper, sugar industries are the example of processing industries. Assembling industries are those industries where the parts or components are assembled to make a useful product. As for example, production of cars, scooters, televisions, computers, etc. On the basis of size and investment, we can classify various industries like that way: light industries and heavy industries. Light industries are those industries which involve a small capital investment and have a short duration production cycle. Industries involved in the production of collapsible tubes, rubber tubes, tin containers, etc. are the examples of various light industries. In contrast, heavy industries are those industries which need a big capital investment for their running and also involve a longer production cycle. Iron and steel industries are the examples of heavy industries. On the basis of the capital employed or invested, we can classify industries into two categories: large-scale industries and small-scale industries. Large-scale industries generally involve higher capital, large number of workers, machinery, and tools. In contrast, small-scale industries involve capital which is not more than 10 lakhs in plant and machinery. As per official classification of industries, industries are classified according to the type of products produced by them as given under the first schedule to the Industries Development and Regulation Act 1951 by the government. For example, drugs and pharmaceutical industries, medical and surgical appliances industries, cosmetic industries, etc. Thank you.